But now that I'm getting more, now that it's getting warmer outside and I'm spending more time out in the sun, I want to make sure I'm protecting my skin. What should I look for when buying sunscreen?
Well, you want an SPF at least 15, probably 30 is better. You want to make sure that it's good for UVA and UVB rays, that it takes care of all the rays. And you need to put it on about 30 minutes before you go out in the sun. Slather it on. Mm-hmm. Don't just use a little teeny bit, but slather it on, and then after a couple of hours, put on some more. And it's just that simple. But you need to get one that's got the protection of both of those rays, mm-hmm. the ultraviolet A and the ultraviolet B. All right.
And here's my public service announcement, too. People of color, such as myself, we need sunscreen, too. I went to the beach this weekend, and my girlfriend, who is Caucasian, was like, do black people tan? I'm like, we've got skin. So if you have skin, put sunscreen on. All right, I'm done. Tim writes in and says, Pat, how many different blood types are there, and is there such a thing as universal blood type?
No, there's not, and I think there...
I thought it was O. Isn't O the universal blood type?
I don't think so. I say so, but I think there are a number of those things, but to my knowledge, there's no universal blood type. So when you take a transfusion, a lot of people, before they have an operation, they use their own blood. You never can tell what's in the blood these days. Mm-hmm. And I think it's safer. You know, if you have an operation where there's going to be some loss of blood, store up. That's what I did facing one operation, which I didn't have. Mm-hmm. I donated the blood to the Red Cross. But you don't know what little bugs are running around in somebody else's blood. So, but you need to test to make sure that mm-hmm. it matches what you are.
Yeah.
All right.
There's a book called Eat Right for Your Blood Type. I am so interested in it. We should get them on the show. But, you know, you've got like A, B, and O. Anyway.
Right. Well, anyhow, I don't know how many numbers they are.
Do you know who you are? Are you an A or B and O?
I have no idea.
I'm an A.
Well, you're an A in a lot of things. You
know? Good answer. That was lovely, Pat. Very good answer.
What else do we
have? Brian says, I was thinking about getting a water pick to help clean my teeth. Is it more effective to floss with a water pick or standard dental floss?
It's a whole lot cheaper to use the dental floss. Water pick is an expensive deal. It's a big thing you have to hook up, and it sprays water up in there. The big thing that you got to remember is probably brushing and flossing is as good as anything, mm-hmm. but you can get inflammation in your gums. It'll get into your arteries and bring about heart attacks and diabetes. And the condition of your teeth is very important to your overall health. There's some people that they have an infection of their teeth and it migrates down to their hips and they wind up with arthritis in their hip. They say, where does that come from? Well, it comes out of your mouth. Mm-hmm. Periodontal disease is the most prevalent disease in the world. And I think the group that doesn't have it is a group in Africa. They're always picking their teeth with sticks and
they eat the roots a lot.
They eat that too, all right. But you have to clean your teeth.
Yeah.
And it's very important, and infection in your gums, don't leave it untreated. But as far as water pricks, I think it's a waste of money. Well, we leave you today with these words from John 15:7. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, you may ask for anything you want, and it will be granted.
Amen, brother. I got stuff I'm asking for.